Hi, I'm John Malos. Welcome to this live edition of Connect With Me, not on the showroom floor, but in Studio B here at Connect With Me on MeTV Fresno. So glad you're here on a Friday morning. Today, we're talking about a very important topic, and that is immigration. How about illegal immigration? How about we'll talk to a Catholic Muslim today? You may have seen the article in the newspaper, the Fresno Bee, recently. She is here live in the studio. We'll talk about all of the above and these issues regarding illegal immigrants and what to do about them. The Trump administration is certainly cracking down. We have an open phone line. The phone number is as follows, 436-ME-TV, option 11. It's the same number, same bat channel. We're back in just a moment. Hi there once again, John Malos here. Connect With Me on MeTV Fresno. Glad you're here. Friday morning, we're not on the showroom floor just yet. In fact, our new computer has not even arrived yet, so we can't put things in place until they are in place, and then we're back on the air downstairs. In the meantime, we're in Studio B, which is fine with me. I like the studio up here. It's very friendly confines, of course, of Ventura TV broadcasting in the upstairs venue, my friends, so I'm enjoying that for the time being. Quick programming note for Monday, we're live back here with Dennis Hart. He is our media expert, and there is so much to talk about. How many untrue statements has Donald Trump made up to this point? Or are they true? Have they come true? And so many things going on surrounding the administration right now with national security and everything else. So much going on with the people in his administration and those in and around it. So we'll talk a little bit about what's going on there and what's going on, of course, in Congress and maybe even here in our own city. In the meantime, you're watching us live on Comcast, channel 375, as usual. If you don't have Comcast cable, it's not a problem because you can watch us at 43.6 over-the-air broadcasting and 13.1 live right now if you have a digital antenna. Later in the day, it comes up at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. I get asked this question a lot. When's the replay come up? 2 o'clock in the afternoon, 13.6 YouTube, 8 o'clock tonight, 4.6 Biz TV. After that, it is up on YouTube. And you'd be surprised. I get more questions about when the replay is than I actually do about when the live broadcast is. The live broadcast is Monday through Friday. Of course, 10 to 11 o'clock, you're watching us now. And there are your replay times, but you need a digital antenna to get those. All right, right to our topic today. Much tension going on around the country right now. Most of it surrounds President Donald Trump and his administration regarding health care, national security, and most certainly immigration. I want to put up the picture on your screen right now and show you exactly what I'm talking about. Most recently, in fact, just within the last week or so, President Donald Trump signed a second travel ban on the six Muslim countries. And you will see that picture of Donald Trump any moment now, I think. Anyway, he signed it with one camera in the Oval Office, just one camera. There were no cameras there to videotape this or snap it except one White House photographer. Okay, guys, behind the glass, are we going to see that photo or not? We don't know. We don't have it. Okay, let's go to a commercial break. Back in just a moment. No.
And away we go.
Here's the place that makes you smile. Stick around and stay a while. We're the home of great TV. That's memorable.
That's me.
Follow me, sir.
Call them classics, call them the best. Call them favorites, be our guest. Every day there's more to come. Watch and see, there's only one. Me TV.
All you have to do is watch me.
Are you kidding me?
Follow me.
That's memorable. That's me.
That's me.
Me TV.
Tune in to Heartland for the best in true country music. Relive.
live vintage specials, one-of-a-kind concerts, and country music's earliest videos. Heartland is the heart of country, the only place where you can find country music, country stars, and country lifestyles 24/7. Heartland, the heart of country.
Now on channel 13.2.
Explore strange new worlds on MeTV. Seek out new life.
Look at him.
I've seen old photographs of this period. Let's get out of here.
Hold it! Hold it right there!
And new civilizations. Only go to Mayberry and the Andy Griffith Show.
Weeknights at 8 on MeTV Fresno.
Okay, back here on the program, hopefully we have some things straightened out here. But as I mentioned, President Donald Trump signed that second ban, of course, just within the last week or so. And so here's the issue. I mean, it hasn't changed much, except Iraq was left out of the picture. They're not on the ban. They're the countries, of course. Now, one person who is worried about the ban more than anyone else, maybe not more than anyone else, is... Change the photo, please. Her name is Thalia Priscilla Arenas, and there she is. She claims to be a Catholic Muslim. She recently gave a speech on the topic to a group at Fresno State and claims to know about 15 Hispanic Muslims. Her activism began at a very early age of 13, maybe 12, 13, but while she was in middle school and continued at Madera High School, where she helped form the Gay Straight Alliance Club.
Gay Straight Alliance Club and the activist in me. My name is Thalia Arenas. This is me in middle school. I began breaking out of my shell at this age. I have always been a quiet student, but also someone who will stand up against injustice. However, this became more true in high school. This is a picture of me and my family when I was in high school. We are Mexican American. My parents are hard workers, and I am the oldest of three. That means I have to lead by example. If my siblings could say one thing about me, is that I work a lot. This memoir is about my activist work in high school that began with the opening of a Gay Straight Alliance Club and the pushback my friends and I received thereafter in our high school. I am a 2007 graduate of Madera High and a former GSA president. During our junior year, my friends and I wanted to have a safe space for LGBT students to meet and discuss similar interests. This is where the formation of a GSA was exactly a space that could allow for this kind of environment, free of discrimination, open to express our identities, and support group for each other. Madera, however, is a conservative town, and the formation of this club caused controversy in our school and our community. As a club president, most of the responsibility landed on my shoulder. Since I had more freedom than my friends to ignite the GSA flame, I led the meetings, attended trainings, and filled out and submitted paperwork to help our club receive approval by Madera High.
All right, live in our studio right now is the one and only Thalia, of course, Arenas, and she is our guest today. She claims to be a Catholic Muslim. We'll ask her about that. She recently spoke to a group at Fresno State about this very topic, and so we'll talk to her about that and much more. 436 MeTV, option 11. We're back with our program in just a moment.
When you like Ventura TV Appliance on Facebook, it's nice. But when you love the Whirlpool appliances we deliver, it's even better. Our website is cool, and it's a good place to start, but you really should touch the merchandise before you buy. Touch the new Whirlpool Ice Collection. It offers a modern style made to create an inspiring kitchen experience. Save big on this Whirlpool Black Ice or White Ice Kitchen. Come in to Ventura TV Appliance and touch the merchandise today.
A top secret location. It's the spies who love me, bringing together MeTV's top super spies to fight evil at a memorable moment's notice. They're daring.
That's right.
Brave.
Now what are we gonna do?
Best we can.
Suave.
Does that apply to me, Oscar?
Possibly.
And smart?
The old finger in the gun trick.
Maxwell Smart.
MeTV Fresno, channel 43.6 and Xfinity 187.
Back here on the program, 436 MeTV Option 11. We are here with our guest today, Thalia Priscilla Arenas. Good to have you here in the studio. How are you?
Good, thank you.
So the introduction got kind of fouled up, okay? We understand that. The monologue was a total disaster today. So what got mixed up in the message is that you're a Catholic Muslim. You have this ban that went into effect, this second ban. President Trump signed the ban. Now we're back to square one. Iraq is left off the ban. Now, you gave this speech at Fresno State claiming that you're a Catholic Muslim. And then, of course, while you were at Madera High School, and this was a few years ago, back in 2007, you helped form the Gay-Straight Alliance. Put all of this into perspective for us, please.
Certainly. So basically, I started as an activist in high school, and it was to push for LGBT rights. So that's really where my activism grew. And then after high school, I went into animal rights, things that I'm very passionate about. I'm very conscious about, you know, these kinds of social justice issues. And then through this time, I had never, you know, abandoned my faith or anything like that. I grew up as a Catholic.
Right.
And then later on, as I became an adult and I was able to form my own decisions about spirituality, then I decided to follow Islam as well.
Okay.
So that's basically how it became. And now I've become an activist also for Muslim rights. So I guess nonetheless...
So do you practice the Muslim religion as well as the Catholic religion?
Correct, yes.
You do? So, how do you do that when the two conflict?
Yeah. Well, actually, I find more similarities regarding, like, our prophets are very similar, how we venerate the Virgin, the Mother Mary, for example. And then I think, and then, like, fasting and things like that, things that are very similar. And Jesus is very important, regardless if you're Catholic or you're Muslim. So I think, if anything, a lot of people have misconceptions about the faith, and they think that they're very distinct, when in reality, they can mesh very well. And for me, they have. I didn't want to leave my Catholicism behind. Because it's something that I grew up with doing all my holy sacraments. It's just that Islam was something more that I wanted to follow personally, and then I was able to blend faiths.
Interesting. But how can you follow two different gods? I mean, the Muslim religion believes in one thing, the Catholic religion believes in another. Obviously, the Muslim religion, they don't believe in Jesus. They don't believe he was the Son of God. They don't believe he was the Savior. And they believe in the Prophet Muhammad.
Mm-hmm. So actually, the God is the same God. It's not a different God. I think the only difference is who we think Jesus is. And even within, you know, even some Christians themselves believe that Jesus wasn't necessarily God himself, but that he was sent by God. And that's where I agree. That's what I believe. And so I actually see them as coexisting versus the opposite.
Yeah, many Christians believe that Jesus not only was... He was part God, he was part man, but if he was the Son of God, he had some of the same powers that God did.
Mm-hmm. I would disagree with that. Even in the Bible, Jesus himself, you know, says not to pray to him, but to pray to the Father. And so I think that's a very important thing that we cannot dismiss, basically. So.
But how do you explain all these different miracles that Jesus performed?
Mm-hmm.
Walking on water, feeding... thousands of people with like six fish,
mm-hmm.
Curing the ill. He obviously cured a blind man.
Mm-hmm.
How do you explain all this? You obviously.
I agree with that. I believe that. So through the power of God, basically. So in Islam, for example, God does not have any. Anybody to his side. He is one and omnipotent being. Versus in Christianity, we had to go to the Father. You have to go through like an intermediary being, right? For example, would be Jesus. And so that's by me cutting out that middle person that I do not believe. I feel that if I have a concern, I go directly to the Father. So that's where it would differ.
So you bypass Jesus?
I bypass because I see him as a prophet. I see him as sent by God.
But he also said, "You cannot get to the Father but through me."
And I actually, I would not agree with that. So I think that's where I would believe that Islam would be the better faith for me because of that. Because I do not believe the opposite.
So you don't you? So I'm confused now. Do you practice the Catholic religion?
Yes, I do.
How do you practice the Catholic religion if you can't? totally accept what Jesus has said.
Mm-hmm. I think by practicing, I mean that I will still go to church. And like, for example, we're in Lent right now, so I still practice that. So I guess that's what I mean.
Right.
And the fact that I grew up doing my holy sacraments. But if I were to select one church that I'm going to go to more, then yes, it would be like a mosque, for example. That's something that I invested more time into.
Right. Okay. Got to take a quick break here. We're talking with Thalia Arenas. She works, by the way, at the SPCA, in case you want to know. She's helping, you know, the animals out there and trying to, you know, have them adopted out so they don't, because it is a kill center, right?
Unfortunately, animals do get euthanized.
Yeah. they get euthanized over there, so you're helping in that. And you've been there how long now?
5 years.
5 years. Okay. Thalia is going to be right back, along with me, your host, John Mallows, 436 MeTV. Option 11, we'll get into the immigration part of this whole thing in just a moment. Back after this.
Giddy up with Westerns, we've got the best ones. Superhero sci-fi Sven, grab the popcorn and stay in. Drama's mystery and action, take a look and see what happens. Carol, Andy, Lucy, MASH, timeless comedies full of laughs.
Hey, that's me!
That's me.
That's me, Chief.
Yeah, me.
Me, 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 you gotta see. That's memorable, that's me.
Me,
TV.
When you're looking for Whirlpool innovation and quality, who has the answers, the selection, the price? Ventura TV Appliance. With billions in nationwide appliance buying power, more than Home Depot and Best Buy combined, we'll help you save. Our low prices on Energy Star qualified Whirlpool appliances save you energy and money, and pay no interest on select models when paid in full within 12 months. Ventura TV Appliance, serving you since 1951.
The necessity to meet was great that we required our community center's help. We went to them, who were pleased to host our meetings, as the staff happened to identify as allies to our cause. And even though we weren't officially meeting on school grounds yet, we had begun our activist work there. I joined the GSA Network's Valley meetings, where representatives from different GSAs come together to discuss their club's progress. I also attended a couple of LGBT youth conferences in order to educate myself on LGBT matters. The GSA Network invited us to lobby for AB 537, the California Student Safety and Violence Prevention Act, at the Capitol, where I spoke to legislative counsel on the importance of this law, which ensures LGBT safety at school. Our group was starting to get a name for itself, although some of the attention was negative since some of our peers started bullying us. One of my friends got a note in her locker calling her derogatory names. Our lunch table was also tagged with the words lesbian table. However, in that situation, we actually embraced the term because that table became solely ours and we loved it, especially since it was perfectly centered on the schoolyard under a tree. We felt empowered every time we walked up to our table. Everyone knew who we were and what we stood up for. Due to the lack of education our peers had about LGBT matters, we wanted to start raising awareness. Our first protest was on National Day of Silence, where we wore shirts to raise awareness on anti-LGBT name-calling, bullying, and harassment in schools. We vowed silence in an effort to encourage our school and classmates to address the problem of anti-LGBT behavior by illustrating the silencing effect of bullying and harassment on LGBT students.
All right, and that is the Gay Straight Alliance, the club that was formed out there at Madera High. Thalia, you helped form that club way back when? Not quite 10 years ago, but not all that long ago, because you're 28 now.
Okay.
So what, maybe you were in high school, so what, maybe
we
about 11?
We started like in 2005, like late in 2005. It didn't get finally approved by the school board until 2007. They gave us pushback.
But it was a struggle because why?
Because the town is a conservative town, so the school board did not want us to have this club. They thought we were a philosophical group or more like political, and because of that, they did not consider this something that they would want to sponsor. So they allowed us to meet on campus, but they would not allow us to announce or fundraise or participate in school activities that other clubs were entitled to.
But you're not. I just to make it clear, you are not a lesbian person.
Correct. Yeah.
Okay.
I'm married to a man.
You're married to a man, but you fought for gay rights.
Correct.
Is what this was all about.
Yes.
Why?
Because most of my friends did identify as, you know, lesbian, bisexual, transgender, whatever the case may be.
Well, why was that issue so important to you?
It was important because I noticed the way that they were struggling when they were growing up. Their parents did not support anything. And unfortunately, some of them were also sexually abused. There was different things that were going on in the house. So because of that, we needed to create some sort of space that they could go to and meet and talk about. It's kind of like therapy. And we were able to be with other people that had similar like beliefs about who they were and how they identified as their sexual orientation. And so that was something that was very important at that time.
All right, let's put up a full screen if we can. It's called District 1 and District 2 as follows. Let's put up District 1 first. It's a full screen. I don't want to talk about with the Madera School District at the time, what their reasoning was for giving this pushback as far as you're concerned. That's the first one up there. So leave that up there for a moment so we can talk about it. Not a school-sponsored program. Is this a part of the pushback by the Madera
Correct.
School District? Okay, this was years ago, though, so... You know, we don't want to pounce on them too much now. Maybe their views have changed. Have they?
Yes, they have continued the Gay Straight Alliance Club. My sister's actually the president this year. So it has been able to continue. And we're glad that basically they saw that it was unjust what they were trying to do. And really, it took the ACLU for them to realize what they were doing was unfair.
So the items that you see on the screen right here aren't necessarily the views of the school board in Madera right now, right?
Yeah, correct. And one thing that was interesting is while they were telling us that we were a political group, and by their definition, religious, philosophical, political groups couldn't be on campus, they did allow the Christian Club to be school-sponsored. So we presented that as evidence that they were being biased.
Okay. They could only meet and have an advisor, no announcements. Let's change to the next one, District 2. No flyers. You couldn't put flyers out on campus
exactly.
at the time, right?
Yeah.
No posting of any kind of bulletins, no fundraisers on campus. And so if you handed out any flyers, what, it had to be in secret?
Yeah, exactly. That's exactly
kind
what
kind of underground?
We had to do. Yeah, so we did make flyers and we would hand them out to the students. And yeah, it was secretively because they would. That was one thing that we were not allowed to do.
All right, Madera. So you felt at the time in that bottom one there, the school district was violating the rights of who? Who were they violating the rights of?
Of the students and the club. So, you know, this club was to
and
represent.
Who determined that?
And basically, it was the school board. They're the ones that ultimately had the decision. So first, the pushback kind of started within our own high school. And then from there, they're like, well, we have to pass this on to the school board. They have to decide whether you can be a school-sponsored club or not. So we went through the meetings. And finally, you know, later in the year, in 2007, they finally accepted us as a school-sponsored club, which we felt also was kind of unfair that it took so long because we were already going to graduate, the people that formed it.
This kind of intertwines with what's going on now a little bit because it showed you were an activist back then in middle school, which is a very young age mm-hmm. to be an activist. Then it continued in high school with obviously the push for the Gay Straight Alliance Club. And now it continues into your adult life with, you know, are you fighting for the rights of those who are Muslim or those who are immigrants, those who are illegal immigrants? What is your fight today? What is your activism today entail?
Thank you. Yeah, it's actually exactly those things that you just described. So specifically, a Muslim Day at the Capitol is coming up in April. That's something that I'm going to participate in, just like I went and participated for the Gay Straight Alliance Club and to, you know, have our rights heard. I'm going to do that again, but now it's going to be for my Muslim community.
Okay, so the question is how and why?
Yes.
Is this type of behavior by you, being an activist, is it embedded in you? Is it just part of your personality? Is it part of your makeup?
I think it is. Since I was little, I was always like drawn to to things that were of social justice, of that social justice kind. I was very motivated to helping others. For example, when I was little, I grew up around animals. So, and then now I actually work for an animal welfare organization. So I feel like nonetheless, no matter what point in my life I have been in, I've always been fighting and protecting the rights of others or those that are less fortunate in one way or another.
Who are you trying to protect the rights of now? Besides animals.
So for right now, I'm very concerned definitely with Trump's policies regarding immigration, because not just being like a woman, but also being Muslim, I'm Hispanic. And because of that, like my family are green card holders, some of them, and they could potentially be affected if he decides to extend this to Mexican people that have green cards as well. So right now it has been targeted to six Muslim majority countries, but I feel that that can potentially extend out further. And then that would affect my mom. For example, we're supposed to be traveling within a week to Mexico, and she has decided not to go. So we're going to lose out on the plane ticket because she's afraid that she will get questioned or something might happen when she's trying to cross back over.
So she's here in the States now,
yes.
Wants to go to Mexico in a week to visit her family, but
correct.
She can't.
Correct, yeah. Our grandparents are renewing 65 years after being married, and she's not going to be there for that because she feels that it's too much at stake, that what if they could potentially, you know, try to take her residency card away, or I don't know, we're just worried with what the things is happening. I try
can't
to convince
they come
her.
Here?
My grandparents, yeah, but we've already organized the wedding and everything in Mexico with other family members.
This is what you told the Fresno Bee in an article just a few weeks ago. And you said, as a woman and as a Muslim, as a Latina, in all of these ways, I feel anything that he, Donald Trump, does is going to affect me. What do you mean by that?
Yeah, so as a woman, I worry that, you know, for example, with what's happening with Planned Parenthood. So I feel that a woman should have, you know, rights to her own body, first of all. And then secondly, we should have, you know, good access to birth control and things like that. That's one thing that worries me. Secondly, as a Hispanic, again, if his bans do extend out further to Mexico with him putting up the wall and things like that, like, I just worry, like, to what point is he going to stop, you know, immigrants from Mexico coming over or going back? So I'm just kind of concerned about that. And then also as a Muslim, because in my other friends who are, you know, from Middle Eastern countries, they're already being affected as of right now. They already have family members that were not able to come over.
Wow. So. Okay. So let me get this straight before I go, though, to a break. And that is, okay, it's still legal to have an abortion in this country. It's not illegal.
Mm-hmm.
It's Roe versus Wade. It's still in effect. U.S. Supreme Court decades ago approved it. So I think what Trump is trying to do now, and maybe what the Republicans are trying to do now with this new health care law that they're trying to push through, it's called Trump Care now, I guess, they're defunding Planned Parenthood. But that doesn't mean that they're outlawing abortion. There's a big difference.
Mm-hmm.
You see the difference?
Yeah, no, yeah, definitely.
So and it doesn't mean just because Planned Parenthood isn't receiving federal money that women can't have abortions. They can still have abortions.
Yeah. I think the problem is that people are going to resort to other means if they don't have good access to Planned Parenthood. So maybe they were going to start raising their rates on things that people couldn't afford. Like, you know, if they were able to afford it before, now they might not be able to. So if Planned Parenthood is defunded, then they might have to start charging something higher. And we might have, you know, people trying to do abortions, you know, and other very unsafe conditions. You know, it's just an assumption, of course, but things like that worry me. That's you know, Planned Parenthood has been around for so long and it's been very helpful. For example, when we were growing up and, you know, if my friends ever needed any services and they weren't able to go to their parents directly, Planned Parenthood was a place to go. They were they would not like share our information. So
do you think there's a compromise on this? There are many people that feel that they don't want their tax dollars going to Planned Parenthood,
mm-hmm.
specifically those hardcore Christians who feel that abortion is a sin. They don't want their tax dollars going to Planned Parenthood. I'm sure you can understand that. Is there some kind of a resolution or some kind of a compromise that you think would work?
It definitely, I think it's hard because, you know, I think the church and the state definitely should, you know, keep separate as they are now. yeah, it's really hard. But I think we definitely need to be more concerned about people's health in this time. So I think at that point...
But if it doesn't go along with someone's religious beliefs to give their money to an organization that performs abortions, could you understand that?
Yeah, I could see that.
And what would be
happening.
The compromise on that?
That's a really good question. And I think since I'm not versed in that, I don't know how to answer that. It's difficult. I can see it.
But you can see the other
side
of it.
Yeah, definitely.
You know, not that they want to outlaw abortion, because women still do have the right to choose what they want to do if they're pregnant, if they want to, you know, terminate the pregnancy, continue on with it. The question becomes how it's being paid for and who's performing it. That's the question, right? Mm-hmm. That's the crux of it. Am I right?
Yeah. And it's interesting that, you know, Republicans are very like pro, you know, life and things like that, which is great. But at the same time, they're not willing to invest in like welfare. So how is that going to work? You know, you want these women to have their babies, yet you're not willing to provide support afterwards. So, right? Because they're going to need probably welfare services. So it's one or the other. They have to choose.
Right. And that's a whole different topic, because mm-hmm. now you have some Republicans, conservatives claiming, hey, look, you have a lot of people coming in from Mexico that are just having babies so they can get the funding too. And so that they see that as an issue.
Mm-hmm.
So that's a big problem too. So they don't want people just coming here having babies and baby after baby after baby and then receiving federal or state funds for that. So that's another issue. But at the same time, you know, you look at all these problems and you think, well, maybe there is a compromise somewhere.
There has to be. Yeah. I think there has to be some sort of compromise because, for example, right now we do have something, at least, that if the mother comes over, has her child here, that child is automatically protected. And I know that to some extent, you know, they are violating the law by crossing illegally. But nonetheless, this child is here and we have to provide for that child. So I think that we need to be more humane in those issues.
Okay, we are here, you're there, 436-ME-TV, option 11. We do have an open phone line. I'm sure a lot of you have a varied... opinions about this and want to call in and offer up and maybe ask Thalia a question. We're back with our guest here on Connect With Me in just a moment.
Unscramble.
Sing, honey, sing.
Call them classics, call them the best. Call them favorites, be a guest. Every day there's more to come. Watch and see, there's only one.
Me.
TV.
Try me.
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 That's memorable, that's me.
That's me.
Me, 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 you gotta see. That's memorable, that's me. Me, 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 TV.
When you like Ventura TV Appliance on Facebook, it's nice. But when you love the KitchenAid appliances we deliver, it's even better. Our website is cool, and it's a good place to start. But you really should touch the merchandise before you buy. Save big with KitchenAid. Right now, get up to a $1,000 prepaid MasterCard when you purchase select KitchenAid appliances. Get the best selection, price, and service in town without waiting. Come in to Ventura TV Appliance and touch the merchandise today.
All right, settling in here with Thalia Arenas. And caller, go ahead. You're on the air.
Yeah, I'd like to direct my question to her on kind of serious about it. You know, I have a niece, 13 years old, and she looks, you know, older. She's pregnant, and the parents are against her having a child, okay? I've gone a couple of times over because she and I have been very close. But at the same time, it's a hard question to say, well, you know, abortion, this and that. I would rather have her, and this is my question to her, I would rather have her have the child and put up for adoption. There's a lot of parents that they can't have children. And you know, if there's an agreement with the parents, I mean, they're just against her having it. And I talked with them, well, I turned purple. But how would you answer that question?
Thank you.
That's my question to you. How would you talk to them or let them know that the best solution would be this, mm-hmm. you know? And they're Catholic, so. Yeah, that's my question for you. Thank you.
Definitely. Okay. Thank you. Unfortunately, not enough people are adopting. I wish that was the case. You know, I wish that, you know, if you didn't want your child, you know, you put it up for adoption, somebody's going to want to take it. They end up in a system, you know, a broken system that's, you know, they're going to be stuck in there for a while. Unless they're babies, maybe they have a better chance. But, you know, where does that leave, you know, the older ones, the teenagers, you know, the ones that are, you know, preteens, like they just don't have a good opportunity of getting adopted. And so I just feel like we need to have both of these things heavily promoted, is birth control and more adoptions. Not only do I promote that at the shelter with our animals, I think that's very important, but I think we need to start practicing that as humans. And so a lot of people say, oh yeah, you know, have your baby, you can put it up for adoption. There'll be a nice family that can take it. Well, how about you take that baby? You know, if you're pushing for her to give it up, then maybe you should, you know, take on that responsibility. So it's an interesting dynamic there, but it's something that we need to be more, instead of being like pro-abortion or necessarily pro-life, we need to be pro-adoption and pro-birth control. I think that's where we can definitely nip these issues, you know, ahead of time.
Yeah, and that's, you know, again, you're going to have opposition on both sides no matter what solution that you come up with, correct. Whether it's abortion, whether it's adoption, whether it's talking about birth control. So how do you talk about, you see, that's a whole different topic. I don't want to get into that, but you know, how do you talk to your teenagers about, hey, I have two teenagers. I don't want them having sex, but if they do, do I want them having safe sex? Do I want them getting pregnant? Of course not. So it's a very tough issue. And also, whether anybody likes it or not, religion always comes into the forefront on this, because there are people, whether you like it or not, or anybody likes it or not, there are very religious people that believe that abortion is against it's against what God teaches. It's a sin. Can you understand that?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, correct. And so, if that's the case, then
we're executing people in jail for
right.
You know, that's on death row. So that's a big contradiction. Mm-hmm. So you have some people on one side of the aisle, they believe in executions, and you have some side of the aisle, the other side of the aisle, they believe in obviously abortion. So what is the answer?
Exactly. So it's interesting when people start, you know, they agree with one thing and yet they contradict themselves the other way.
Both sides do it.
Yeah, it usually happens. And so I think we need to start with pushing birth control in the high schools.
Right. Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. Edward, you're calling. Go ahead. You're on the air with Thalia, one of our favorite guests here. Go ahead.
Sure. Morning, Thalia. Edward. Listen, several questions. I'll have a little dialogue with you if I could. You believe, since you're Catholic and Muslim, am I correct?
Yes.
Correct.
Okay, correct. Do you believe in the Quran and the Bible?
Yes. The Quran teaches us.
Do you believe in both?
Yes, correct.
Okay, do you believe in Christ Jesus as the Son of God?
No, not as the Son of God, but I do believe that he was a messenger of God.
Okay, so you really don't believe the whole Bible, or you believe in bits and pieces of it, sounds like.
Yeah.
Or you don't even believe in it.
Yes.
It says that he's the Son of God, the Bible. These are holy scriptures. So so you would go more for the Quran than the Bible? Am I correct or wrong?
Yeah, I think you're correct, actually, yes.
Okay, All right, with that being said, I mean, because the Holy Scriptures are against abortion, if you didn't know already. There is a scripture
right.
where God says that he knew you even before you were born. He knows of you and knew you. So that's nice. Check it out if you haven't already. I'm sure you probably, people mention it to you. If you haven't already.
Hang on a second, Edward. Hang on a second. Don't hang up. Do you get criticized for having that political view?
Yes.
Or religious view?
Yeah, I do.
And how do you handle that criticism?
Yeah, definitely. I don't mind. You know, I don't mind that people think that in some way that I'm contradicting myself, right? Because I believe in these religions where, you know, for example, LGBT rights are not necessarily something, or for example, like gay marriage is not something that should be accepted, nor abortion or things like that. I'm my own kind of person, and I have my own beliefs. And so, yeah, it's not going to align perfectly to, you know, what the Bible says and what the Quran says, which is no problem to me. I have been able to work these things out in my own persona, so I'm okay with that.
Yeah, Edward, correct me if I'm wrong, though, because I haven't, and I'm not ashamed to sit here and say the truth. I haven't read the Bible cover to cover, okay? Maybe I should one day and sit down, but I'm just being honest with you. I'm not lying. So once I decide I'm going to do that sometime before I die, maybe, who knows, in the next 10 minutes or so, I don't know. Does it not say in there that Christ actually, Jesus said, you do not get to the Father, but through me. Am I right about that?
Correct. Yes, he's our mediator for forgiveness, our counselor, our lawyer. You know, some people call him our lawyer. He's our mediator between God. He's our sacrificial lamb.
Here's the contradiction though I have, and I believe in Christ, but the contradiction that I have is if Jesus and if God, the Father and the Son, are so forgiving, they know all, they see all, and they understand all even before it happens, and they're compassionate. They have so much compassion. Would they have compassion for a person who has questions about how this can be? And exploring other possibilities. Do you think Jesus would have compassion for that?
Yeah, I think so. I think there's a lot of questions, even in the Old Testament. I mean, where Job, you know, had a dialogue with God himself and questioned why you're doing this, why this took place, why me? And there's other issues that I believe in the New Testament. People have dialogues, and there's no problem with that. But the question... it's not, you know, as some people would say, it's of Christ Jesus. I'm trying to think of the word. It's not, you know, we know Christ Jesus is Son of God. It's not, it's who he is. What are you going to do with him?
Not everybody believes that. So what I'm asking is, do you think God and Christ have enough compassion and understanding for someone who maybe has a lot of questions about this and maybe some doubts?
Yes.
And maybe be exploring other things and maybe saying, okay, maybe God gave Jesus the powers, but maybe he's not really God. Maybe he wasn't the Son of God, but he was the chosen one.
You slice it. Yeah, no matter how you slice it and what you say, you're still dead in your sins. See, this is what, again, what Scripture says. You're still dead in your sins, and you need somebody like Christ Jesus.
Here's what I'm asking, Edward, here's what I'm asking. Thalia or other people who have questions or maybe doubts about whether or not Christ was actually the Son of God, well, just by asking the question, will they go to hell?
According to, if have a choice of hearing Scripture and the gospel, and they refuse it. And I wish I had another way to... there is no other way.
So if you refuse it, you just said it. If you refuse it, then maybe you have maybe you're in trouble.
You're in trouble because you're still dead in your sins. You still need a Savior, no matter how you... I didn't write the book. This is what the Holy Scripture says.
Right.
Still need a Savior because you're dead in your sins, and in other words, there's no other way. Either you're for me or against me. That's another Scripture. You're for me or against me. You cannot be on the fence.
And I'm not against. I am not against God.
Right, Edward. I have another call. Can I take that?
Sure, take it. You got it.
Okay, but you gave us a great call. Something to think about. I appreciate that.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Scripture is nice to read it.
All right.
If it takes that, go for it.
Thank you,
Don.
Bye.
Bye.
All right. Caller, are you there? Caller, are you there?
Hello?
Yeah, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Thank you. I don't have a question. I just have a comment about this lady, Miss Arenas. I just wanted to tell you that before she starts giving... advice or opinions, I think she should get her mind straight, whether she's Catholic or she's a Muslim, because there is a very, very large gap into that, even if she says that it's very, very similar. I think that and so forth. So is this a program about immigration, or is this about religion? And we don't. I personally do not care to hear about religion, because that's why I have a church that I go to. I want to know about what her topic is about immigration. That's what she should be talking about.
Well, she's free to talk about whatever she wants to talk about. It's a free country. But this is kind of a program. It's kind of a combination of both, because what I tried to explain at the top of the...
A combination, that's fine. I understood right at the beginning that it was about immigration.
But here's the thing. Let me finish. It's a program about her being an activist. Her activism started in middle school with the Gay Straight Alliance and trying to form that club out at Madera High School. That's what I was trying to explain. It continued into adult life with trying to fight for the rights of animals. She works at the SPCA. Now she's trying to fight for the rights of Muslims and immigrants who are in this country. So she has a pattern of behavior throughout her life, beginning in middle school. Are you following me?
I understand all of that, yes. I thank you for explaining. But I think that she should get one topic straight and then the other and then the other one. That everything is so mixed. And right now what she's talking about, a little bit, they jump into one thing to another. And I love your program. I watch it religiously.
Well, I understand that, but
her topics.
But I can't speak for her. She has to speak for herself, and she's conveying her.
Well,
I'll wait
for her answer that in that topic.
Yeah. Okay.
She starts with the immigration, then she starts with the other one, then she starts about the welfare and the this and the that. I think that what all these people are fearing is that they're going to take away all the freebies and then be done with it. I'll hang up now, and I'll wait for her.
Okay, got another call coming in. I'll let you answer that, but we've got to take it. Let me say thank you for calling. Let me see if another call is coming in. I think it was. Oh, yeah, it was coming in. I'm going to let you answer that, but let me take another call, and we can maybe kill two birds with one stone here. Caller, go ahead. You're on the air with Thalia. You've really lit up the phone lines here, Thalia. Go ahead. You're on the air, caller.
Hi, John. I just wanted to ask your guest, pro-women's rights, as she stated earlier.
That's another one.
How could she convert to a religion such as Islam, who idolized this man, Muhammad, when at 55 years of age, he married a 9-year-old girl? I mean, why was she?
Okay. I'll have her answer that after I take this other call. I appreciate the call, but I got other callers coming in. That's another good question. Okay, caller, thank you. But I have to take this other call here. Caller, go ahead. You're on the air.
Hi, I wanted to ask the guest if she locked her house tonight or today when she came to the show.
Did you lock your house?
Always do.
Yes.
Well, what about locking our country? What about people that come in illegally? I mean, I'm the most compassionate person you know, but how many stray people do you allow to come into your own home? I'm sure there's a lot of people that would like to lay down right now in your house.
Definitely, yeah. And I actually foster. I'm currently fostering a youth. So I do let people.
How old?
He is 16.
Okay.
He's 16 years old.
Any problems?
Is he documented or undocumented?
No, he's documented, but some of his family members are not.
He's not illegal.
There's a lot of you could have your house as a sanctuary. Now let's move on to the Muslim faith. You say that you believe in Jesus Christ and Muhammad?
Correct.
Okay, what year do you live in? What year is it to you? Is it 2014 or is it 1647?
Oh, it's 2017, and that is why I have these blended faiths, because I have the option. Versus in the past, you know, if we were in the early maybe 1950s, I would not have the rights to choose as I so do now. So I'm
not sure. You're missing the point, sweetheart. Muhammad was born 700 years after Jesus. Do you realize that?
Yeah, and actually, yeah, I definitely realize that. Yeah, I have no problem with that.
Do you attest to the Sunni faith?
Neither.
Of Muslim?
Neither.
Or a Shiite?
Neither. That is not important to me.
What do you mean, neither? Do you either believe Muhammad was the ultimate prophet or there were other prophets after Muhammad? Do you understand?
No, I know what you mean.
But
do you believe in Muhammad?
Yes, I do believe in Muhammad.
Okay.
Correct.
And what about, hang on, caller, don't.
But, like, I know that in, like, for example, some Middle Eastern countries, there is, like, this fight, right, within the Sunnis, the Shiites, and other groups. That's not something that I necessarily follow. I don't agree with that because it is, unfortunately, creating chaos, and that's not something that I agree with.
What do you stand for? I mean, you could believe
I stand for myself. I stand for my faith. I think right now there's kind of like a mix-up of who I am because I was raised as Catholic, but I think that should not be the focus. I think the focus is my activism and who I've been, you know, growing up as, not necessarily getting deep into my religion because that's my personal faith. Even, you know, certain people of certain, like, for example, some Christians are not going to believe the same things, and that's okay. So...
I think
don't you wear a burqa?
No, I don't. I do not believe in covering.
You don't cover yourself?
Okay. No, if I'm going to go to the mosque, I do it out of respect. Just like even when I go to church, right? When I go to like St. John's, I do cover because I think it's out of respect you do that.
I'll tell you, I don't mean to interrupt, but I've heard of cafeteria Catholics, those that like to pick and choose what portion of the Catholic religion they like. But I've never heard of a Catholic or a cafeteria Muslim because... Islam means complete subservience to Muhammad. And to be Muslim means that you believe only in the word of Muhammad. You don't believe in government. You don't believe in Trump. You don't believe in any of that kind of thing.
No, that's incorrect.
Muhammad is your savior.
No, actually, God is my savior. I do not follow any prophets themselves. So even though, yeah, that I know that Prophet Muhammad is venerated by some Muslims a little bit more than they should, I do not personally practice that.
Oh, interesting. John, great show. I can't wait to hear more.
Yeah, so would you like me to have Thalia back as a guest? Because she's leaving to go on vacation here for a big-time wedding down there in Mexico. And so do you want me to ask her back as a guest? Because she's been here before. She's a terrific guest. Hey, caller, are you there? I guess you're gone. Okay, no problem. But, you know, I can't believe we're almost out of time already. This show takes up an hour of our time, but it's already 10:51. So let me follow up on some of the caller's question. That first lady that called in, she was saying you sounded confused about yourself. Are you confused about who you are? And if not, can you explain fully so she can understand where you're coming from?
Yeah, definitely. I do not feel confused at all. I think I've already come to terms with the things that I believe in. That's why I put myself out there, at least to come to the show, because I know I was going to be questioned harshly on my beliefs.
But it's not the first time you've been questioned.
Exactly.
Harshly.
It's not the first time. And so I don't mind. I think that there's many people that have different beliefs. And it's just that I was put on the spotlight because of it. And there's nothing wrong with that. They can ask all they want. But I think the reason why it maybe things got a little bit confusing was because I was being asked about several different topics. And I'm giving my opinion, my personal opinion about what I believe in each one of these topics. Now, are they going to, you know, mesh very well? You know, is it, you know, is Christianity going to accept that as a whole or Islam? Maybe not. Maybe, you know, most of the people that follow those religions are going to be conservatives themselves. But I am my own person, and I do consider myself a feminist. And because of that, my ideas are going to be completely different than, you know, your regular person that might just follow
that. So you're a feminist, you're an activist, you're a Catholic who believes in Catholicism, but doesn't necessarily believe that Jesus was the Son of God. And you...
Well, I guess it's not necessarily that I believe in Catholicism. I think that's where it gets confusing. I did my Holy Sacrament, so because of that, I consider myself a Catholic because I did everything that I needed to do, and my family is.
But you don't necessarily believe everything in the Catholic religion.
Exactly.
And what they believe.
Exactly. So
all you're saying is you grew up in the Catholic Church, but you don't necessarily agree with everything that has gone on there.
Exactly. Yeah. That's what I'm. Yeah.
Yeah.
So, and the reason I say that, and I would continue to call myself a Catholic Muslim because to me, the Bible is just as important as the Quran. In the Quran, it says that we shall read the gospel as well. And so that's important. A lot of people don't know that. That is, it's
advocated. But as the caller pointed out, do you feel like you're a subservient to Muhammad?
No, not at all.
Who pointed out was born 700 years after Jesus Christ.
Correct.
And who married or was involved with a 9-year-old girl.
Correct.
You agree with that kind of practice?
I wouldn't agree with that kind of practice. And from my understanding, what I've been taught by, you know, local Muslims, I'm not going to say you speak for every Muslim throughout the world, right? But what I've been taught, it was because he was taking her under his wing, and that's what they did during those times. So now, I mean, whether I agree with that now, no, I do not agree with that. I do not agree with slavery as it has been, you know, shown in the Bible and right. things like that. So there's things that I definitely do not agree with to be currently practiced.
There are things in the Muslim religion, such as the oppression of women.
Mm-hmm.
Do you agree with that?
No, I don't. I do not agree that women should be oppressed.
But they are.
I know they are. And I think that it's unfortunate, but unfortunately, some of these things do happen, like in places such as maybe like Afghanistan or other places like that, because they
Saudi Arabia,
exactly. So the problem is not with local Muslims, and people want to associate them as being of the same, you know, of the same practicing faith. When the people come to America, their beliefs have shifted because they have to adapt to the American way of life. And so when they practice their religion here, they're very people that are very peaceful, very accepting, and things that we share culturally. And I'm not going to say that every Muslim is Middle Eastern, because there's a lot of Hispanic Muslims in the United States. There's quite a bit. There's a high percentage. About 10% is actually Hispanic.
All right. So you have a 16-year-old at home.
Yes.
Adopted?
No, we're just fostering.
Fostering. You're fostering. Okay. Is he legal or illegal?
He's legal.
He's legal.
Yes.
Okay. What do you think about Fresno becoming a sanctuary city? Because the mayor's already said, no, it's not going to happen yet. Dahlia, we're not going door to door to evict people and deport them.
Okay. So I would like to see Fresno as a sanctuary city. Unfortunately, you know, that's not something that the mayor has said that he's going to agree with. And I think that's important because I have, like, you know, seen families that are very much worried about them being separated. And then the children are going to end up in a foster system. And then we're going to end up with families having to need to provide some sort of help. And so if we can keep them together, at least here locally, that would be very beneficial. Thankfully, though, the Fresno Unified School District has said that they will not be giving information to ICE officials if they do come and try to take one of their students.
Right. And so it sounds like Fresno Unified Schools are a safe haven for these people. But what's wrong with what Mayor Brand's saying? They're not enforcing it. They don't have the time, the manpower, the resources to go door to door.
Correct. Yeah. So thankfully, he's probably not even necessarily going to be dealing with any immigration issues because they have so many things on their plate that they have to
deal with. Can you understand what Mayor Brand is saying, too? He's saying, look, if Fresno becomes a sanctuary city, we're going to lose out on all this federal money. We need the federal money. Mm-hmm. Would you agree with that?
Yeah, I would agree with that. So I know.
So he's stuck in a very difficult position.
Yeah, I can see that.
Right. Okay. So just to clarify what the woman said as far as the caller, there's no struggle within you as to who you are.
Exactly.
Who are you?
Who am I? I am Dahlia. I am an activist. I think that's a good way to end the type of work that I've done. It's somebody who cares about different issues, and there's nothing wrong about caring about these different issues. And maybe they don't have to necessarily, you know, blend very well, but that's okay. In my own way, somehow I make it work.
Do you mind all the attention and the criticism coming in even from some of our callers? I'm sure. You've gotten your share of criticism for the Catholic Muslim situation within you.
Yeah.
Does it bother you?
I think the only thing that bothers me is that people are getting too technical. I think they just need to see past that and realize that I'm just a person who has this different blended beliefs, and that's it. We just need to leave it at that. I don't think you have to dig into my persona. I think just the fact that I'm a person who wants to help is what's important in me.
Right. But there are so many there's so many differences between Catholicism and the Muslim religion. You can see why they're asking so many questions. So,
yeah, definitely. Yeah, yeah. And but, so I think that the reason they have so many questions is because they haven't studied Islam as much. But
all right.
I encourage anybody to learn.
Dahlia, thank you so much for coming in. And come back again, please.
Appreciate it.
All right?
After your vacation. After vacation.
You can come back. We can spend more time. All right. See you back here on Monday with Dennis Hart. Connect with me on MeTV Fresno. Have a good weekend.
like Ventura TV Appliance on Facebook, it's nice. But when you love the KitchenAid appliances we deliver, it's even better. Our website is cool, and it's a good place to start. But you really should touch the merchandise before you buy. Save big with KitchenAid. Right now, get up to a $1,000 prepaid MasterCard when you purchase select KitchenAid appliances. Get the best selection, price, and service in town without waiting. Come in to Ventura TV Appliance and touch the merchandise today.
If you have a need to promote your business or event, please consider MeTV Fresno for your next